One of the most important things we do for the warfighter right now is get them the technology they need to complete their mission and get it to them as quickly as possible.
And one of the fastest, most innovative ways to test and deliver a new aircraft? Keep it on the ground. Thanks to an advanced pulley system called Magic Wall, engineers at the Naval Air Systems Command can fully test an aircraft and its systems inside the anechoic chamber before it's ready to fly.
As a tester, it's exciting to think that we can put an aircraft in a basically a building and make it think it's anywhere in the earth and give it different data. We can simulate targets. We can simulate commercial aircraft. We can simulate if we're doing an attack.
If you're trying to figure out where you've seen Magic Wall before, look no further than your television screen. This dynamic testing capability is an upgraded version of the camera system used to film professional sporting events. Magic Wall can move at high speed and change directions quickly, much like an adversary in the operational environment.
And what we're using is we're using a live virtual constructive environment to do this. We're doing live transmissions, live responses. Where the aircraft believes it's in flight, so it's virtually, you know, flying, and we wrap that environment around it.
It allows us to do things on the ground that we could never achieve in the air. We would never have that many targets or that breadth of the operational environment available to us. It preserves our security with what we're actually testing in the chamber, and it also preserves life on the aircraft.
Magic Wall is already making history. Recently, engineers put the system to the test using a P-8 Alpha aircraft.
This dynamic interrogator test put the live aircraft into the chamber while it thinks it's flying and flying against dynamically moving virtual targets.
The test was actually an infrastructure development to recreate tests we've done on the aircraft in the past to determine if we could use the chamber for future testing of systems that haven't been tested yet or that are coming out in the future.
Then our hope is that certifying agents will then accept that the data that we gather in the chamber is as good or better than the data that we achieve through flying in space.
Virtual flight from the ground saves time and money. It also offers testers a first-hand look at how the system performs in a highly complex combat scenario.
We can set up virtual environments, simulated environments, and run through those ad nauseum without spending the thousands and thousands of dollars required for jet fuel, for aircraft maintenance that you would do in an actual flight test.
With the chamber, we're not susceptible to weather or other flight test issues that may cause delays, so we're able to get the aircraft in the chamber quickly and efficiently, determining deficiencies that may be with the system, correct those, and then get the aircraft to the warfighter quickly.
And speeds up the approval process, because now what we do is we turn a high-risk flight test to a almost no-risk ground test.
Anytime you're able to get more data in less time and for less cost, that's what's going to propel programs forward. You're going to be able to make a better product, and it's going to be able to happen much faster. You won't need a week of flying. You'll need, 3 days, and you'll have probably closer to 2 weeks worth of data if you had just done it in the air.
It's all part of a growing push for capabilities-based test and evaluation, where systems are designed and tested with the end in mind.
What excites me the most about capabilities-based T&E and the live virtual constructive aspects of that is it allows us to have more confidence that what we are actually delivering to the warfighter will work when it's most important and doesn't fail our warfighters when they're actually in combat.